I'm standing here next to a pear tree, not just any pear, but a sekal pear, AKA the sugar lump. And as you can see, it's loaded with fruit. My guesstimate, my quick guesstimate is that this tree, once thin, you can see there's a need to thin these clusters to one fruit. But still, when thin, this tree will probably have in the vicinity of 200 fruit on it, and that's a good thing. Okay, it's being grown to an open center form. Let's look at the four main branches here. One, two, three, and four. The idea is that these branches go up and out and into the light, and you have a nice big round circular opening at the top. Well, that's the concept. Pears are a little cantankerous in several respects. They don't usually come into bearing as quickly as stone fruits or apples. It could take 5, 6, 7, 8 years for them to bear a crop or a good crop. On the other hand, they live for a long time. There are pear trees in the hills of Tuscany, guesstimated to be in excess of 200-250 years old. So, you want an open center tree with a nice wide circular opening. The nature of the pear is that it's upright, candelabra-like, if you will. So I'm gonna make some adjustive training maneuvers on this tree to just splay out the primary branches and open up that top. But before I do that, I'm actually gonna make an adjustive pruning cut. If you look at this branch, it's the most vigorous of them all. And I would like it to be a little less tall and vigorous, so I'm going to prune that out. And in doing that, this is now more along the lines of the other three branches in terms of height and vigor. But in doing that, I also began the process of allowing light and fall into the core of the tree. So let me get my spreaders here and let's adjust these branches. And the idea again is just to nudge them a little bit. So I'll put one in here and splay this out thusly, and then I'll put one across here. Do something similar, and I'll replace this one, sorry. Let me try this one again. I'm good. And this last one here, let's just push it out a notch like that. Okay, so you can see these now cant out a bit and you have a nice wide circular opening. And that was also enhanced by me making a thinning cut at the top of this branch, which was more vigorous than the rest. And this allows so much light down into the core of the tree. When you fix branches like this, it probably only takes about 6 or 8 weeks for them to stay in place, and then you can remove the training tools.